be on God's side.
与上帝同边站。
Be on God's side.
与上帝同边站。
I like to talk. I like to get to know people who are real, people whose feet are on the ground. They are practical. They are real.
所以我要讲到，就是说，一个很实际的人，他们生活的话呢，他们的生活是很脚踏实地的。
When it hurts, just say it hurts.
就是。很真实的一种的感受。当他们受伤，他们就讲他们受伤。
If I need to do something about it, I need to do something about it.
他们要去做一些事情，他们就讲说我要把事情做好。
I don't like to hear people just say pray for it and it's okay.
然后呢，我不想要听到就讲说祷告吧，事情就会好了。
It's true. In some ways, yes.We always need to pray.
但我们知道有一些时候呢，我们是时刻要为这些事情祷告。
But there are things that we have got to do rather than just pray.
但是有些事情呢，我们不但只要祷告，我们更加是要去行动的。
How many understand that?
多少人能够明白？
If I'm hungry,
如果我很饥饿，
you can't ask me to pray and I'll be okay.
你不能够叫我祷告，我就会饱足了。
You need to give me some food.
你必须要给我吃一些东西。
I need to bite. I need to eat. I need to swallow.
我必须要去咬，我要去咀嚼，我要吞下去。
Life can be full of tough times.
然后我们的生活呢，可以是非常艰难的。
Even a nation, our nation, right now.Is also and still going through tough times.
这即使是我们的国家，现在我们仍然的是在艰难的时刻。
Some Christians gave up our nations.
有一些的基督徒，他们已经是对我们的国家抱着没有多大的希望了。
They don't believe in any leaders anymore.
他们也不再相信任何的领袖。
Because of all the disappointments.
因为太过失望。
Well, people do disappoint us.
当然，人们会使我们失望。
If I make you the prime minister, you also don't know what to do with the nation.
那如果你是这个的首相的话，我相信你也不懂得如何的来到去设立这个内阁。
But let us understand a few facts in life.
但是我们要来到去明白呢生活当中的事实。
The presence of tough times does not mean the absence of God.
然后在艰辛艰难的时刻呢，不代表上帝不存在。
Just because our nation has been going through 60 years of tough times.
即使是我们的国家度过了六十年很艰辛、很艰难的时刻
，It doesn't mean God was not with us.
不代表呢，上帝没有与我们同在。
Just because you are going through tough times in your own life,
在你的生活的当中，你经历艰难。
It doesn't mean that God doesn't love you, God doesn't bless you, God doesn't want to give to you.
那不代表说上帝他不爱你，他不赐福于你，他不会来到赏赐给你。
On the other hand, the presence of God doesn't mean the absence.Of tough times.
所以也同样的，有上帝的同在呢，也不代表我们不会面对艰难的时刻。
We sometimes misunderstand what is happening around us.
很多时候呢，我们对在我们四周围发生的事情呢，我们有这种的混乱。
We sometimes tell people, if God is with you, you have no problems.
所以有些时候我们会告诉别人说，上帝与你同在呢，你就不会有任何的问题。
If God is with you, there will not be storms in your life.
如果上帝与你同在的话，你的生命绝对不会有风浪。
Now that is not true.
这是不对的。
When Jesus was in a boat, they had a big storm.
当耶稣在船上的时候呢，门徒们面对极大的风暴。
tough times are just realities in life.
在我们生活的当中，会面对艰难的时刻呢，是很真实的。
It is not true when you have tough times, God is not there.
当然，如果你有这个的艰难时刻，神不在那边呢，这是不对的。
It is also not true when God is there, you don't have tough times.
当然，如果有神同在，你不会面对到艰难的时刻，也是不对的。
The reality is that tough times demand tough decisions.
那事实上就是呢，在艰难的时期呢，我们需要做出很艰难的决定。
I find that in life.It's easy to do things. It's easy to do things, but the hardest thing in life is to make the right decisions.
然后我们在艰难的时刻呢，我们可以做事情，但是要最困难的就是什么呢？就是你做出正确的决定。
We are capable in doing a lot of things.
我们可能啊，就是很有能力做很多事。
The most difficult thing for every one of us.Is making right decisions.
那最难的就是呢，我们如何做最好，做出对的决定。
Because we know that right decision leads to right actions.
因为我们知道呢，做出对的、正确的决定呢，就会让你有对的行动。
Am I right? Right decision leads to right actions.
所以，一个正确的决定或者是对的决定呢，会带来正确的行动。
Wrong decisions lead to wrong actions.
错误的决定呢，就会带来错误的行动。
Now that's why during tough times we need to make tough decisions, meaning we need to make the right decision, which can be tough.
所以呢，这个的意思，艰难的时期呢，你的决定。你需要做出很艰难的决定呢，就是说你会很困难的做出正确的决定。
When we go through tough times,
当我们经历这个的艰难的时期
，very often we pray this way.
很多时候呢，我们是如此祷告。
God, I'm going through tough times, difficult times.
说神啊，我在面对艰难的时刻。
God be with me.
神你与我同在吧。
God be with me.
神你与我同在。
God be with me.
神你与我同在。
Reality is, you don't need to get God to be on your side, because God has already said, "I will never leave you." I will never forsake you. I will always be with you.
这其实呢，我们不需要求上帝与我们同边站，因为呢，上帝永远是和我们同在的，因为他说过，他总不撇下我们，总不丢弃我们。
I want to share something with you that will cause a breakthrough in many of your lives this morning.
所以今天早上我要跟大家分享的真理呢，让很多人你的生命会面对突破。
We pray, God be with me. God be with me.
很多时候我们跟神祷告说，神与我们同在。
We are asking for what we already have.
因为呢，这样子的祷告就是说我们已经有的，我们还在跟神求。
When God say, "I will never leave you, I will never forsake you," that means God is with us.
然后神说我永远不会丢弃你，又不会撇下你，是说神永远与我们同在。
Couple of weeks ago, I was talking about Jacob.
然后呢，我在几个星期前跟大家分享有关雅各的故事。
Jacob.Always wanted God to be with him, to bless him, to bless him, to bless him.
那雅各呢？他总是想要上帝与他同在，上帝要赐福与他。
He would do whatever he could to get his blessing.
他竭尽所能呢，就是要得到他的这个的福气、福分。
He would lie, he would cheat, he would defeat as long as he is blessed.
所以他不管用骗的、欺骗的方式啊、诈骗的方式，或者是用狡猾的方式呢，他就是要得到他的这个的啊福分。
Jacob had this understanding, which was a wrong understanding.
那雅各呢，他有这样子的一个理解，他这理解是错的。
He had this thought, if I am blessed, it equals God is with me.
所以他有这种的错误的想法，就是说只要我得到上帝的赐福呢，上帝就与我同在。
If I am blessed with the birthright, that's equals, that means God is with me.
那如果我是拥有这个长子的名分的话呢，那上帝就与我同在。
If I have no problem,
equals God is with me.
如果我的生活当中没有问题的话，就代表说上帝与我同在。
He would do what he could to get what he wanted.
所以他竭尽所能的去得到他要得到的东西。
Because to him, that is called God is with me because I am getting what I want in my own way.
因为他这样子做呢，就是说我要上帝与我同在，然后呢，我用我的方法去得到我要的东西。
One day.He felt God was not with him.
然后有一天呢，他就感觉到上帝没有与他同在。
Esau and 400 men coming to kill me.
他看到这四百人呢要来杀死他。
That's mean God is not with me.
意思说上帝没有与我同在。
He was so afraid.
他非常的惧怕。
Because he felt God was not with him.
因为他感受到呢，上帝好像没有与他同在。
That's why he wrestled with God.
所以因此他跟上帝呢角力。
He wrestled with God.
他跟上帝摔跤。
Oh God, you be with me, you bless me, be with me, bless me.
所以上帝，你要赐福于我，你要与我同在。
You see, God is always on your side.
上帝呢，总是与我们同在，就是在我们这一边。
God let Jacob do whatever he wanted to do, even.In the wrong way.
上帝呢，他容许雅各去做他要做的事情，即使他是做错事的。
All the time, Jacob did it the wrong way. God allowed him to.
所以呢，一直以来呢，雅各呢都是做错事情，那是上帝容许。
Because God was waiting for a moment when Jacob would be ready, where God wants to change him.
所以因为上帝在等等雅各呢，然后到有一天上帝能够改变他。
So during the wrestling, God changed him.
所以当雅各跟上帝摔跤的时候呢，上帝就改变他了。
Jacob was changed.
雅各被改变。
He was being transformed.
他极大的转变。
Instead of God bless me, God bless me, I do what I want, but you bless me.
所以他从这种一直要上帝赐福他，一直要上帝和他同在的情况里面
，I will lie, I will cheat, I will get it. God bless me.
他就是用尽方法，用骗的，他就是要上帝赐福他。
God touched him.
上帝触摸他。
The Bible says, since then, Jacob was changed.
在圣经就告诉我们说，那个时刻开始，雅各就被改变了。
Instead of God be with me.
他就想说，与其神与我同在。
Jacob had got to hold on to God.
雅各呢，他就紧紧的抓着上帝。
And walk with a limp.
然后呢，就就是瘸腿的这样子行走。
How many of you know that Jacob changed sight?
多少人知道说雅各呢，他现在转换方向。
He was standing on his own side.
他是从站在自己的那个方向
waiting for God to bless him.
然后呢，就站在自己的那个方向呢，等着上帝赐福他。
But when God changed his life,
那是当上帝改变他的生命的时候
，He stood on God's side.
他就赶快站在上帝那个方向。
Then he started to walk with God.
他就开始与上帝同行。
All the time,
很长。
Jacob was actually.In the presence of God.
其实呢，这个雅各呢，他就是在上帝的同在里面。
But again, just because you are in the presence of God, it does not mean that you are standing on God's side.
那不代表说你在上帝的同在里面呢，你就站在上帝的那一边。
We are here in the presence of God.
我们现在每个人都在上帝的同在里面。
Some of us we are standing on God's side. Some of us are not standing on God's side.
有些人站在上帝跟上帝同边站，有一些人却没有跟上帝同边站。
Some are rejoicing in the presence of God.
有些人呢就在上帝的同在里面欢喜。
Some are looking at the watch when is our preacher going to finish.
然后有一些人呢就看着手表说我们的讲员要讲到什么时候才结束呢
？I'm talking about we can be in the presence of God.
我们可以大家都是在上帝的同在里面。
But does not mean.That we are on God's side.
那不代表说我们就跟上帝同边站。
There was a time whereby Moses and the Israelites, They were gathered in the presence of God.
然后呢，有一次摩西和以色列人在上帝的同在里面。
It was soon after Aaron had made the golden calf.
然后呢，就是在这个呢，亚伦塑造这个金牛犊之后。
Moses said to the people.
然后呢，摩西呢就来到去处理这些的人民。
There are two sides.
因为那时候呢，他们已经分成两党了。
We are in together in the presence of God.
我们大家都在上帝的同在。
But in the presence of God, there are two sides.
但是在上帝的同在的里头呢，却分成两个党派。
And Moses said,
然后摩西就说
，Who would come to the Lord's side?
然后到底呢，谁要站在上帝这边
？Who would stand the opposite side?
谁要去对面的那一边？
All were in the same presence of God.
然后两个这样子的不同的不同的，他们都是在上帝的同在里面。
All in the same presence of God.
都在上帝的同在里面。
But there were two sides.
但是他们却站在两个边。
So Moses said.
然后摩西就说
，Who is on the Lord's side?
然后到底呢，谁是在上帝这一边
？Who is on the opposite side?
谁是在对面那一边？
When tough time comes,
当艰难的时刻来到
，tough times demand tough decisions.
所以艰难的时期呢，需要做出艰难的决定。
Hear this. Tough times demand tough decisions.
所以艰难的时期呢，需要做出艰难的决定。
Tough decisions can only be made.Tough people.
所以艰难的决定呢，是由坚强的人做出。
You need to make the desperate decision.
你必须要做出呢这种很难的决定。
Your decision has to be yes or no before the Lord.
因为你在神的面前呢，你的决定不是是是和不是。
Are you loving the Lord? Yes or no?
然后你爱神呢，是和不是。
But if whether.
那我没有这种可能如果也许
Are you serving the Lord or are you not?
你是在侍奉神还是是还是不是
It's tough decision.
这是很艰难的
It's not easy to say I want to serve.
不是当我们讲我们要服侍神的时候呢不是很容易的说出这个的决定
Because it takes commitment, it takes time, it takes sacrifices.
因为侍奉呢需要有委身需要有牺牲的
And every one of us who are serving, we know somehow, sometime, somewhere, it will hurt us.
那很多时候呢，我们侍奉的时候呢，也会被伤害。
So tough decisions are made by tough people.
所以艰难的决定呢，是由坚强的人做出。
And these tough people, this tough person, this tough individual were not created.These tough individuals, tough people, they were formed, they were changed, they were specially made.
所以这个坚强的人呢，是由上帝所塑造出来的。
That's why the Bible says.
所以因此圣经告诉我们说
，In Isaiah 43, that Jacob was created, but the tough person that walked with a limp, that held on to God and walked a limp.That tough person was not Jacob. That was Israel. Israel was formed. Jacob was just being born. Was just being created.
所以在以赛亚书的第四十三章第一节，他这边说：“我创造雅各，但是我塑造以色列。”所以这个以色列呢，是上帝呢用很艰难，就是跟他摔跤，在经过一段的这种的挣扎呢，以色列才被塑造出来的。
How many of you understand?Tough people are formed.
所以呢，坚强的人是塑造出来的。
That's why we say we have discipleship.
所以因此我们说我们需要门徒训练。
That's why we say we have life groups.
所以因此我们说我们有小组。
That's why we want you to come together and let us help to form one another.
所以我们需要大家一起呢，来彼此的塑造。
Come together, help to build one another.
然后我们彼此的建立。
I know it's so convenient to stay at home and watch live service in bed with breakfast provided.
这很多时候呢，我们在家里头一面吃早餐，一面看这个的直播，这是很享受也很方便的。
But that is not the purpose of God to bless you that way.
但是呢，我相信上帝绝对不是用这样的方法来要赐福于你。
God wants to form you, not just to bless you.
因为上帝不只是要赐福于你，他更是要塑造你。
And when God forms you.He does not form you to make you look good.
所以上帝呢，他塑造你呢，不是只是为了让你，就是能够好看。
He form and make you so that you can fulfill, you can arrive your purpose in life.
所以他塑造你呢，是让你能够去完成，达到你人生的目的。
Am I right? Toyota.Built Toyota cars.
然后呢，这个的 Toyota 呢，就是他塑造这个 Toyota 的车。
Not just for the cars to look nice and beautiful.
然后不只是让这个的类型的车呢看起来好看。
But so that the car can operate, can be functional, can fulfill its purpose. The purpose is not to look good.The purpose is to bring you comfortably from one place to another place.
所以这车子呢被造成呢，不是为了只是外表的好看。这车子被造成呢，就是让你能够很舒服的从一个地方去到另外一个地方。
Now that is why God takes your life and allow you to have a personal encounter with Him, so that you can be like Jacob. Your life can be touched.Your life can be changed and be transformed.
那为什么呢？我们需要跟神有这种的个别的相遇，所以因此我们的生命很像雅各这样子呢，我们能够被塑造，能够被转换，我们能够去达到我们人生的目标。
Let's come back to the Israelites.
我们回到再看以色列人。
Because of time, so I'm not reading the.Verses too much. Let's look at the Israelites.
那我们看以色列人。
They came out of Egypt.
他们从埃及出来。
They stood at the edge of the promised land.
那么就来到这个的应许之地的边缘。
That was a tough time, a tough decision for them.
那这是他们需要做出很艰难的决定。
There's a difference.Between taking the land and entering the land, or there's a difference between entering the land and taking the land.
所以呢，进入到应许之地呢，跟得到应许之地是两回事。
You can enter the land, but you doesn't mean that you take the land.
所以你能够进入应许之地，但是不代表呢你就得到它了。
Like Moses,
就好像摩西。
The Bible says Moses came.Near the river Jordan, he looked into the land. He saw the promised land from across the river. He saw the promised land. That was Moses.
这告诉圣经告诉我们说，摩西他来到约旦河，他就远远的仰望着这个的应许之地。
But Moses never had the opportunity to enter the promised land.
但是摩西他没有这样的机会呢，能够进入应许之地。
The Israelites.
这些的以色列民。
They send the 12 spies.
他们就差派这十二个探子。
They entered the promised land.
他们进入到这个应许之地。
Just because they entered the promised land.
就因为他们进入到应许之地。
It does not mean that they took over the promised land.
不代表说他们已经得到这个应许之地。
They were able to enter.
他们能够进入。
But they could not possess the land.
但是他们没有办法得到那块地。
How many of you understand that? It's like many of us.
就好像我们很多人
maybe in the marketplace in our businesses
在我们的职场在我们的生意里面
we see our blessing
我们看见我们的祝福
we even entered our blessing
我们即使呢很多时候已经进入到这个的祝福里面
we could almost feel it we could almost smell it we could almost taste it
我们已经是差不多能够嗅到能够碰到能够吃到了
But somehow we cannot possess it.
但是呢，就是我们就是没有办法去得到它。
When we are about to possess it，
当我们要差不多得到它的时候
，it slips away from our hand。
这个的祝福呢，就从我们手中溜出去。
When we are about to take it，
当我们要去拿的时候
，it vanishes in thin air。
哦，那它就在空中消失了。
We were able to see it。
我们能够看见它。
We were able to even taste it。
我们可能是能够尝试。
But we were not able to possess it。
但是我们没有办法去得到它。
Why?
为什么呢?
Because we expect God to bless us without us standing on His side.
因为呢，很多时候呢，我们期待上帝赐福于我们，但是我们却没有和上帝同边站。
The Israelites thought.
这些的以色列人以为。
That they were ready.
他们已经预备好了。
430 years we were slaves.
他说我们成为这个的奴隶430年。
We were good.
我们真的是很好。
We were skillful.
我们呢手中有技巧。
We can build anything.
我们可以建造任何东西。
We can do anything.
我们可以做任何东西。
The Bible says when all these hands left Egypt.
然后呢，圣经告诉我们说，当这些的手离开埃及的时候
，Egypt didn't know what to do。
那埃及人呢，不晓得要如何做事了。
Because all the skillful hands left the land。
因为这些充满技巧的手呢，离开了埃及。
The same with us today in Malaysia。
同样的，我们在马来西亚。
If all the Indonesians go back。
如果我们这些的印尼人回去的话
，All the Filipinos go back。
这些的菲律宾人都回去的话
，All the Bangladesh go back。
这些的孟加拉人都回去的话
，All the Myanmarans go back。
这些的缅甸人都回去的时候
，Malaysia goes hungry。
然后呢，马来西亚人就会很饥饿了。
All the housewives begin to cry。
所以家里面的主妇呢，开始哭了。
Do you understand what I mean? The Israelites。
这些的以色列人。
They felt that we have been trained for over 400 years. We are skillful, we are professional, we can do anything, we can take anything.
他们想到说，他们在430年，他们被训练，他们认为呢，他们是能够去得到一切。
When the testing came,
当试验来的时候
，they realized they were not ready.
他们才发现说，他们没有预备好。
They were not ready.
他们没有预备好。
Let me go into a little bit of story, then I finish. The Bible says they sent in 12 spies.
然后圣经告诉我们说，他们差派12个探子。
One from each tribe, 12 spies.
然后每一个的支派呢，都派一个人。
They went into the land.
他们就进入到那块土地。
They spied the land for 40 days.
他们就在那块土地呢，窥探了40天。
What did they see? Let us look at the Bible.
那他们看见什么呢？我们来看看圣经。
In Numbers 13,
在民数记的第十三章
，in verse 23,
二十三节。
What did they see? Numbers 13:23. They saw the fruit of the land.
他们看见什么呢？他们看见这块土地里头的果实，非常的漂亮。
You go supermarket, you buy a cluster of grapes, you pick it up, it's about 30 grams.
然后呢，可能呢，你去这个的超级市场呢，你拿起一串葡萄来呢，它可能才13个 gram.
But the Israelites went to the land, a cluster of grapes. They needed two persons to carry with a pole.
但是呢，他们进到这个应许之地，他们看一下呢，这个的一串的葡萄需要两个人来扛。
And they saw the pomegranates, big, juicy.
他们看到这些的石榴、无花果。
They saw the figs, big, juicy, and sweet.
他们看到这些的石榴、无花果是非常的丰盛的。
They look around the land.
他们就视为
的观看。It's a land of abundance.
他们就看到这个土地实在是太丰盛了。
They saw that it was a land flowing, as if flowing with milk and honey. There was so much in the land.
就看到这个的土地呢，是流着这个的蜜和牛奶的。
The 12 spies went in.
所以这十二支派呢，他们进入到这块地。
They saw two things.
他们只看见两件事情。
The first thing they saw.
第一件他们看见的。
Was the fruit of the land.
就是这块地的他们的果实。
12 of them saw the same thing, the fruit of the land.
所以呢，这十二位探子呢，都同样看见这地的果实。
The 12 of them also saw another thing, the second thing in the land.
然后这十二位探子呢，他们也看见了另外一个东西。
There were other people, other tribes in the land.
他们就是看到呢，这块土地呢，有其他的支派。
In verse 29, there were the Amalekites, the Hittites, the Jebusites, the Amorites, and the Canaanites.
然后看见亚玛利人、赫人，也不是亚摩利人，还有迦南人。
And these are not simple people.
他们说这些人不简单呢。
In verse 28, it says these people who live in the land, they were strong.
所以你看，他第二十八节说，只是在那地的人强壮。
They are not weak.
他们不是软弱的人。
They were not like ordinary.
他们不平凡呢。
And the cities were fortified.
所以你看他们的城呢，非常的坚固。
Like Jericho, it was fortified.
然后呢，很像这耶利哥城，非常的坚固。
And very large.
然后很大。
The people were like giants.
他说这些的人呢，很像是这些的巨人。
While they saw the fruit, the beautiful fruit of the land, they were so happy.
他们首先看见这块土地的果实，他们非常的高兴。
They were so thankful. They were so full of faith.
所以他们真的是充满感恩和信心。
But again, when they turned around, they saw the giants in the land.
但是转个身呢，他们就看见这块土地的巨人。
Instead of full of faith, they were full of fear.
他们本来是充满信心，但是现在他们充满惧怕。
What I want to tell you is this:
这是我告诉大家的。
The 12 spies saw the reality of the land, the fruits, and the giants.
所以，其实这十二支派的人呢，他们的确是看到关于这块土地的真实性，就是果实和巨人。
All of them saw.
每一个人都看见。
In life, the fruits and the giants. Often come together.
所以呢，在我们的生活当中呢，果实和巨人都是一起来的。
You want to be blessed, there will be enemies too.
那如果你要被赐福的话，一定会有敌人来的。
You want to move up, there's a gravity that pulls you down.
如果你要往上的话呢，一定有地心吸力把你拉下来。
You want to move forward, there is a pull that pulls you backward.
然后呢，可能你要向前呢，但是一定有阻力把你拉后。
You want to be courageous to serve, there will be discouragement that deter you.
然后你要有这种的勇气来服侍呢，可能就有许多的拦阻让你不去服侍。
That's why life can be tough.
所以因此呢，生命是可以很艰难的。
Because while you have the fruits, you also have.
因为你不但只会看到果实，也会看到巨人。
The 12 spies came back.
所以这十二位支派的他们，十二位探子呢，他们就回来。
They were telling the truth.
他们的报告呢是很
真实的。They were telling the reality what they saw.
所以他们将他们所看见的都报告出来。
None of the 12 spies were lying.
然后没有一位的探子呢是在讲骗话。
They were telling what they saw.
他们将所看见的都说出来。
But among the 12 spies,
但是在这十二支派十二的探子里面
，there were 10 of them that stood one side, and 2 of them stood a different side.
然后十二个探子呢，有十个呢是站同一边，有另外两个呢是站另外一边。
There were 10 of them when they saw the fruit, the giant.
那有这十位呢，让他们看见果实和巨人的时候
，They were so full of fear.
他们充满着惧怕。
They have forgotten their faith.
他们已经忘记了他们的信心。
They have forgotten their God.
他们已经忘记了他们的神。
They forgot that God had led them.
他们忘记了这位神曾经领导他们。
They forgot that God has promised them.
他们忘记了这位神曾经应许他们。
They forgot that God has trained them.
他们忘记这位神曾经训练他们。
They forgot that God has formed them.
他们忘记这位神曾经塑造他们。
They have forgotten that God would be with them.
他们忘记了神是与他们同在的。
There's so much fear.
他们太多的恐惧。
When you have fear,
当你有恐惧的时候
，You do not know how to look up anymore.
你就不懂得如何向上看了。
You look around yourself.
你就会看你的四周围。
And you look at yourself.
你看着你自己。
The more you look around, the more you look at yourself.
你看的越多，你四周跟你自己的时候
，You begin to feel that you are getting smaller.
你就会感觉到自己越来越微小。
And you begin to get weaker.
你就觉得自己越来越软弱。
As you become smaller and weaker, you become more fearful.
那如果你觉得自己越微小越软弱的时候，你就越惧怕。
When you become fearful, you become jumpy.
那如果你觉得越惧怕的话呢，你就觉得自己没有办法做到。
Everything seems to frighten you.
那每一件事情呢，就能够让你感觉到惧怕的。
Something comes, you just jump.
然后有些事情发生的时候，你就跳走了。
Something comes, you just hide in the cave.
然后有些事情发生了，你就躲在山洞里面。
That's why.They have lost respect for themselves.
然后因此呢，他们对自己呢也完全的对自己没有这种的信心了。
They became so jumpy, 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 that they said, "We have become like grasshoppers." That's what they are, always jumping around.
所以呢，他们就觉得自己一直跳来跳去呢，觉得自己呢已经是像蚱蜢那样了。
Grasshoppers, they don't fight. Anything comes, they jump away.
所以蚱蜢发生事情呢，他们是不会去征战的，他们就是跳走的。
That was the problem with the 12 spies, with the 10 spies.
所以这就是这十二个探子呢，他们的问题。
It started off, they thought they could do it.
他们一开始呢，他们以为他们能够做得到。
They had a lot of confidence that they could do it.
他们太有信心了，说他们能够做得到。
They thought they could enter and take it.
他们认为呢，他们是可以进入，可以去得到的。
They thought they were good enough.
他们以为自己很好了。
Sounds like some of us.
然后很像跟我们一些人。
They thought they were capable enough.
他们觉得他们自己能够。
But as they step in,
就当他们踏入的时候
，they begin to doubt. They begin to have a question mark.
他们就开始怀疑了，有问号在心中了。
They doubt whether they could do it.
他们就开始怀疑到底他们能不能够做得到。
As they begin to doubt more and more,
所以他们开始越来越多怀疑的时候
，they come to.A belief system. They believe they couldn't do it.
所以他们就形成一种的信仰的系统，他们就开始相信他们是没有办法做得到。
When they start believing they couldn't do it.
当他们开始相信他们做不到的时候
，The Bible says they could not, they did not, they were not allowed to enter in.
所以圣经就告诉我们说，他们没有办法，他们也无法进入到。
This was the scenario of the 10 spies.
这就是这十位探子的情况。
Hear this. In life, there are a lot of realities.
在我们生活的当中有很多的真实。
All these realities are true.
然后这些事实呢是很真实的。
But do not let the devil turn your true report, your reality.Into an evil report.
所以你不要讲，不要让魔鬼呢，将让你的这种的真正的报告变成恶性。
Yes, tough times are real. They are like giants in the land.
所以艰难呢是很啊，这很真实的，它就像这个的应许之地里面的巨人。
Tough times can be discouraging, can be frightening.
所以艰难的时期呢，可以是非常的让你沮丧和让你惧怕的。
Tough times can cause you to turn away from God and look at yourself and seeing yourself getting smaller.
所以艰难
and smaller and smaller.
艰难的时期呢，可以让你呢，把啊，就是从上帝的那个眼光注视上帝的眼光，到注视自己，觉得自己很渺小。
Tough times are real and true.
然后这个艰难的时期是很真实的，很真的。
But don't let the devil or don't let the enemy.Take what is true and turn it into an evil report.
所以不要让魔鬼呢将这种的真正的这种的报告呢转变成恶信。
The other two spies.
那其他两位的这个的探子。
The Bible said they had a different spirit.
然后圣经告诉我们说他们有另一样不一样的心智。
In what way they had a different spirit?
到底他们是在哪方面是不一样的心智呢
？They saw what the 10 spies saw, the fruit.And the giants.
他们所看见的也跟其他的十个探子看见的一样，他们也看见了果实和巨人。
They were not the ones who saw the fruit and forgot the giants.
他们不是呢，只看见果实而忘记了巨人。
But when they saw the fruit and the giant,
当他们看见果实和巨人的时候，
even though they were fearful of the giant,
即使是他们看见巨人，他们是很惧怕的。
They turned their fear into faith.
但是他们却将他们的惧怕呢化为信心。
This is a powerful truth.
这是很有能力的真理。
Whatever you are fearful of, turn that fear into faith.
不管你对什么事情你是充满恐惧惧怕的，你要把这种的恐惧化为信心。
You are fearful about the marketplace.
你对你的职场充满着惧怕吗？
Turn it into faith.
你要开始把它化为信心。
You're fearful about your business. Turn it into faith.
你对你的生意是充满恐惧吗？把它化为信心。
You're fearful of your finances. Turn it into faith.
你对你的经济感觉到恐惧吗？把它化为信心。
You're fearful about your future. Turn it into faith.
对你的将来充满恐惧吗？把它化为信心。
You're fearful about your children. Turn it into faith.
对你的孩子充满恐惧吗？把它化为信心。
Whatever that you are fearful of.
不管你惧怕什么。
If you are hurt, turn it into faith.
然后，如果你受伤害，把它转为信心。
If you are depressed, turn it into faith.
如果你是受压制的，把它转为信心。
That was what the 12 spies did.
对，好像
the two spies did.
就是这两个探子他们所做的。
They carried a different spirit.
他们的有不一样的心智。
They turn it into faith because they know that God is still greater, taller, bigger, stronger than the giants.
所以他们能够将恐惧化为信心，他们知道呢，上帝比这个巨人是更大、更好、更强的。
Because they believe what God had given to me, what God has given to us, no one, not even the giants, can take away.
因为他们很相信呢，上帝所赐给他们的呢，就算是巨人也是无法夺取的。
If I walk with God, no giants can ask me to walk away from God.
如果我跟神同在的话，没有任何的巨人呢能够来到。拆除我跟上帝。
Understand what David said.
我们要明白大卫所说的。
In Psalm 23,
在第诗篇二十三篇。
He says, "Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death."
他说，即使是我经过死荫的幽谷。
Oh, I fear no evil.
但是呢，我却不惧怕。
Why? Because even during tough times, God is with me.
为什么呢？因为在艰难的时期呢，上帝与我同在。
Valley of the shadow of death is tough time.
他说这个的死荫山谷呢，就是指到这个艰难的时刻。
I fear no evil.
他说我不怕遭害。
I turn my fear into faith because God is with me.
因为我把我的恐惧化为信心，因为神与我同在。
Good times, bad times, God is with me.
好的时候，不好的时候，上帝都与我同在。
David said something else.
大卫他还说了
，God。Your rod and your staff, they comfort me.
他说：“你的杖和你的竿都在引导我，在安慰我。”
You know why?
为什么呢？
Because I am following where your rod and your staff is leading me.
因为呢，我在跟着你的杖和你的竿，因为你的杖和你的竿在引导我。
God, I am not just a person who believes that you are with me on my side.
上帝呢，我不只是相信说你与我同在，在我这一边。
I am a person who knows how to stand on your side, like Israel, who knows how to walk with you.
所以呢，我也是懂得如何站在你那一边，好像以色列人那样子呢，与你同行。
That's why these two spies were different.
所以因此这两位探子呢，他们很特别。
The ten spies gave an evil report.
然后呢，这十位探子呢，他们报信是报恶信。
The two spies gave a good report. Let us go in. Let us go in.
但是这两个探子他们就说，让我们进入吧，让我们进入吧。
The ten spies started off.
然后这十位探子呢，他们就开始了。
They thought they could do it.
他们一开始呢，他们就觉得说他们可以做得到。
Then they doubted that they could do it.
然后他们就开始怀疑他们能不能够做得到。
Then they didn't believe that they could do it.
他们就开始相信说他们做不到。
So they couldn't enter in.
他们就无法进入。
That was the ten spies.
这就是那十位探子。
The two spies with a different spirit.
然后另外两位探子不一样的心智。
Who stood on God's side.
他们就站和上帝同边站。
In the same way they started off, they thought they could do it.
同样的，他们开始的时候，他们觉得自己能够
做得到。They knew they could do it.
他们知道自己能够做得到。
They knew they could do it.
他们知道自己能够做得到。
Oh, they knew they could do it.
他们知道自己能够做得到。
They knew they could do it.
他们知道自己能够做得到。
They knew they could do it.
他们知道自己能够做得到。
Eventually, the Bible says the two spies went into and possessed the promised
land. 直到最后呢，圣经告诉我们说，这两个探子进入到这个应许之地，得到应许之地了。
It is all because.
这是全都是因为。
During tough times.
在艰难的时期。
They made the tough decision.
他们做出艰难的决定。
To stand on God's side.
他们站在上帝那一边。
To stand.On God's side.
他们站在上帝那一边。
I believe that God is speaking to some of us today.
我相信今天上帝对某些人来说话。
It is not good enough that God is with you.
所以呢，上帝与你同在还不够好。
You need to learn.
你必须要学习。
To make a decision.
做一个决定。
Whether through good times or bad times, I will stand on God's side.
好，不管是在好的时期还是不好的时期，我都跟上帝同边站。
Okay, just take 5 minutes and finish.Jesus went through tough times.
耶稣他也曾经经历艰难的时期。
At one time, he was so heavy in spirit.
有一次呢，他灵里非常的沉重。
Because he was going through just too much in his life.
因为呢，他生命经历太多的事情。
The Bible says Jesus went to the Garden of Gethsemane.
所以圣经告诉我们说，耶稣他来到这个客西马尼园。
It was a tough time for him, and it demands tough decision on his side.
所以对他来说，那个是很艰难的时刻，他需要做出很艰难的决定。
Should I? Should I not?
我要吗？还是不要
？It's too difficult for me.
对我来说太难了。
It's too bitter for me.
对我来说太苦了。
Should I? Should I not?
我应该吗？还是我不要？
He was hearing a lot of voices, a lot of noises around him.
在他的四周围有太多的声音和杂音了。
Because he spent 3 years raising his 12 disciples.
因为他用了三年来到门训他的十二位门徒。
Almost every day he would speak to them, he would disciple them.
他们差不多每一天都对他们说话来门训他们。
And he knows.
但是他知道。
One of his disciples called Judas.
有一位。
Not you, but Judas.
其中的一位的犹太人犹大。
He has gone out into the dark.
其中的一位他的门徒呢犹大。
He was the one who said he loves me.
他说他爱我。
He was the one who said he would stand with me.
他说他会与我同。
But this Judas has gone out.
但是呢，他这个位犹大呢就出去了。
He's receiving the 30 pieces of silver.
他呢就用了这个30两银子。
So that he can sell me to the authority.
所以他能够将我出卖。
If Judas had come to me directly and say, "I don't like you, I hate you, I want to get rid of you," I can accept it.
那如果犹大来到我的面前就说我不喜欢你，我想要离开你，我能够接受。
But Judas has gone out.
但是犹大呢，他出去了。
Under pretense that he loves me.
他呢，就是让我觉得他爱我。
And Judas will be coming back.
然后犹大会回来。
Still saying, "I love you, Jesus."
他还是对我说，耶稣，我爱你。
He still come back.
他还是回来。
And pretend that he loves me.
然后呢，假装他爱我。
He will show everybody that he loved me.
他让所有的人都知道说他爱我。
Because when Judas come back,
当犹大回来的时候
he's going to greet me with a kiss.
他会用亲吻来到跟我问候
to tell everybody he loves me.
来告诉所有的人他爱我
It was not easy.
其实是不容易的
When a deceiver is coming to deceive, it was a noise that stirs, that disturbs him.
因为呢，这个的欺骗者要来欺骗他，所以耶稣基督的很多的这种的杂音来到干扰他。
Is it worth it to die for mankind?
然后呢，到底为人类死值得吗
？I have got another 3 disciples.
我还有另外三位门徒。
Peter, James, and John, they were my best.
所以这三位我最好最好的门徒，彼得、雅各、
They were closest to me.
他们跟我很靠近。
They said, "If I go to prison, they would go. If I die, they would die."
他们说，如果我去监牢，他们跟我一起下监；如果我死的话，他们会跟我同死。
I asked the 3 disciples to just stay there, wait with me, and pray with me.
那我只是叫他们三位 就是在附近呢等我，跟我一起祷告。
I went into the garden. I prayed for a while.
就当我进到这个的这个的克西马尼园的时候呢，我在里边祷告。
I came out.
我出来的时候
，They were sleeping.
他们在那边睡觉。
Not shocked, like, not good, like.
然后内心里头觉得他们怎么可以这样子
？Disturbing, 哎。
真的是会影响的。
Why you don't wait with me?
那你为什么不能够跟我警醒片刻？就是警醒片刻。
Come and wake up, just pray.
起来，跟我一起祷告。
Pray for me, just for an hour.
为我祷告一个小时而已。
He went back in the garden again and prayed.
他就又再回到克西马尼。
A lot of noises, a lot of voices, and he was confused.
很多的声音，很多杂音，他也混乱了。
Struggling.
在挣扎。
Until his sweat became blood.
然后以至于呢，他的这个的汗如雪地。
Came back to the three disciples again.
他又再回到三位门徒的面前。
They were still sleeping.
他们还在睡觉。
Come and wake up.
起来吧。
Pray for me. Pray with me.
为我祷告，跟我一起祷告。
He went in the garden again and again.
他又再进去克西马尼园，又再次祷告。
Father, where are you?
他说：“父啊，你在哪里
？”Father, what is going on?
父啊，到底发生什么事了
？This is my toughest time in my life.
这是我的生命当中最艰难的时候。
One has gone out and coming back to betray me.
有一个呢出去了，回来就要出卖我了。
Three of them were sleeping.
三个在那边睡觉。
He came back the third time.
他第三次再回去看他们。
Jesus said something which was a miracle.
耶稣说了一些事情是神迹啊。
Jesus saw them sleeping.
耶稣看着他们在睡觉。
You're still sleeping.
他说你还在睡觉。
It's okay. Go to sleep.
他说没有关系，你们继续睡。
It's okay.
他说没关系。
Go to sleep.
继续睡。
Do you know what happened when Jesus said that?
你知道当耶稣这样子说的时候是发生什么事吗
？He went in again and again.
他又再进去祷告。
Until he could fine tune himself.
他知道呢，他能够调整他整个的心态。
Until he found peace with the one who had gone out and will be coming back to betray him.
知道呢，他即使是知道那个出去回来会出卖他的。
Until he found peace.
他想到这样的事情，他开始心中很平静。
When his disciples were not listening to him at all,
他看到他的这三位亲爱的门徒却没有听他的话，他心中平静了。
You want to sleep? It's okay.
他说你要睡的话，你就睡。
You want to betray me? It's okay.
你要出卖我的话也没关系。
Because I have found oneness, singleness of heart, mind, and spirit.With my father,
因为呢，我的灵呢，已经在我的父的那边呢，得到了这种的平安。
If you want to know how to stand on God's side, you need to find the singleness of heart, mind, and spirit with God.
所以，如果你要懂得如何在很艰难的时期做决定，你就要懂得如何呢，来到神的面前。
Noises over there, it's okay.
然后能够跟就是能够跟神有同样的心思和灵，即使是在外边有这种的朝声
，voices against it, it's okay.
各样的这种的杂音跟你对抗没有关系。
Enemy is coming to betray.
这敌人
it's okay.
敌人要来到背叛你没有关系。
Your own people let you down, it's okay.
你自己的人呢让你失望没有关系。
Because I'm standing on God's side.
因为我就和上帝同边站。
This powerful truth, I believe, belongs to somebody today.
这个大能的真理，我相信对某些人来说。
Stand on God's side.
跟上帝同边站。
Whatever tough times that you have.
不管你面对怎么样的艰难事情。
Whatever tough times that you've been going through.
不管你会经历怎么样的艰难时刻。
Whatever situation that you are in.
不管你在怎么样的情况。
Stand on God's side.
你要站。跟上帝同
边站。Tough times demands tough decisions.
因为艰难时期需要做出艰难的决定。
Tough times demand a change of side.
因为呢，艰难的时刻呢，你需要换边站。
When you go to go through tough times,
当你经历艰难的时期
say it is okay,
你要跟你自己说没有关系
I will still worship my God,
我仍然的敬拜我的神
say it is okay,
跟自己说没有关系
I will still raise up my hands,
我仍然要举起我的双手
going through tough times,
即使是我经历艰难的时期
say it is okay,
跟自己说没有关系
I still pray, I still fast,
我仍然的祷告我仍然的禁食
I still praise, I still give thanksgiving.
我仍然的赞美，我仍然的感恩。
Going through tough times,
经历艰难的时期
is tough,
是很艰难的。
But I will still serve.
但我仍然侍奉。
I am still committed.
我仍然的委身。
I am still there.
我仍然在那里。
It's all because I know what it meant to stand with God on God's side.
因为我知道呢，什么是叫做你站在上帝那边和与他同在。
It is not good enough that God is with me.
那只是有神与我同在还不够好。
I still need to choose to stand on God's side.
我仍然要做一个选择，我要跟上帝同边站。
I want to pray for you.
我要为你来祷告。
That you know how to make this decision today.
你懂得如何的来到做决定。
Let there be a change in your life.
在你生命里头有这个改变。
Let this encounter bring a change in your life.
让这个你跟上帝的经历能够改变你的生命。
Let's arise to our feet.
让我们从我们的位置上站立起来。
Or let's arise to our feet.
我们从位置上站立起来。
If you are going through tough times, tough situation, whether at work, in the marketplace, or at home.
不管是在你的职场、你的工作、你的家庭，你面对艰难的事情。
Some of you have issues that you are struggling within yourself.
可能有些人呢，你在为着自己的一些事情，你很挣扎。
I'd like everyone to just stay with us for a while. We are going to finish together.
我要请大家每个人，我们一起的来祷告。
Just don't move around for the time being. Just give me a few minutes.
然后呢，请大家不要移动，我们再多几分钟就结束
了。When you're going through tough times,
当你经历这个的艰难时刻
，Yes, God is with you.
是神与你同在。
But this morning,
但是今天早上
，Make this tough decision, this right decision.
但是你要做出这虽然是很艰难的做决定，但是你要做出正确的决定。
Whatever I am going through right now，
不管我面对经历什么艰难
，I still choose to stand on God's side。
但是我仍然的选择要站在上帝那一边。
If that's what you want, you just raise up your hands where you
want。如果这是你想要的话，不管你在哪里，把你的手举向神。
Or just raise up your hands right。
不管你在哪里，把你的手举向神。
Father God, I pray in the name of Jesus.
姐夫，我奉耶稣的名字祷告。
Oh yes, I pray in the name of Jesus.
我奉耶稣的名字祷告。
The Lord, this is the time.
主啊，这就是时，就是这个时刻，就是这个时刻。
This is the time for an encounter.
这就是这时刻来到跟神相遇。
Oh yes, this is the time for an encounter.
就是这时刻与你相遇。
God was waiting for Jacob.
上帝他等着雅各。
He was waiting for Jacob to be ready.
他等着雅各预备好。
For years, Jacob has been doing the wrong thing.
因为呢，雅各呢，他做很多的错事。
God didn't stop him.
上帝没有阻止他。
For years, he was doing things that God didn't like.
然后呢，他做了很多年是上帝所不喜悦的
事情。God didn't stop him.
上帝没有阻止他。
In fact, God continued to bless him.
即使上帝继续的赐福于他。
But God waiting for the occasion.
但是上帝在等那个时刻。
Whereby Jacob would be ready.
当雅各预备好了。
So he can become.Change, transform, and be Israel.
因此，他能够被改变而被塑造成为以色列。
God is looking at your heart.
上帝在看着你的心。
Some of you are ready.
有些人你预备好了。
You're ready to be Israel.
你预备好成为以色列。
You're ready to be touched.
你预备好被触。
You're ready to be changed.
你预备好被改变。
You're ready to be transformed.
你预备好被转化。
You're ready to change side.
你预备好里边被改变，你预备好要来到换边站。
You tell the Lord.
你告诉神。
I'm ready.
你跟神说你预备好。
Oh, I'm ready.
你跟神说你预备好。
I'm ready.
你预备好了。
I'm ready.
你预备好了。
Father God, I pray in the name of Jesus.
天父，我奉耶稣的名字祷告。
That these are people who are ready this morning.
这些你的子民，他们今天早上已经预备好了。
Father God, cause a touch. Cause a touch upon their lives.
天父，你来触摸他们，触摸他们的生命。
Just like the way you touch Jacob.
就好像你如何触摸雅各。
Just like the way you touch Saul.
就好像你触摸扫罗
Oh, give them a touch.
主，你触摸他们
That this morning,
今天早上
they will change side.
他们会换边站
This morning,
今天早上
they will be transformed.
会有带来转化
This morning,
今天早上
they will have a new beginning.
他们会有新的开始
I pray in the name of Jesus.
我奉耶稣的名字祷告
that there's such a grace that covers them.
主啊，你的恩典临到他们
there's such a blessing that covers them.
你的祝福临到他们
that when they leave this place,
他们离开这个地方的时候
they walk out as a new person.
他们是新的人走出去
they walk out as a new Israel.
他们是新的以色列人走出去
they walk out as a new instrument of your kingdom.
他们走出去是一个你的国度的新的器皿。
I commit them into your hands, Almighty God.
我把他们都交在你全能手的手中。
In Jesus' mighty name.
奉耶稣大能的名字。
In Jesus' mighty name.
奉耶稣大能的名字。
Oh, and everyone say.
每个人说 ，Amen.
Amen. Let's give God a big applause.
我们给神最大的掌声。Hallelujah.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.